A spirometer is a diagnostic device that is used in pulmonary function testing to measure the volume and speed of airflow during a breathing cycle. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Spirometry is a PFT test that measures airflow and volume as it moves into and out of the patient's lungs. This means that spirometry testing occurs during both the inspiratory and expiratory phases of the breathing cycle. This test is done by having the patient take a deep breath into the spirometer, followed by a fast maximum exhalation. So, what exactly is a spirometer? As we mentioned, it's one of the most common devices used during pulmonary function testing. When a patient breathes into and out of a spirometer, it measures the volume of air and the flow rate during the whole ventilatory cycle. Since it measures both volume and flow, this means that it's useful in identifying both obstructive and restrictive respiratory conditions. A spirometer can be used to obtain the following measurements: tidal volume, minute ventilation, vital capacity, forced vital capacity, functional residual capacity, FEV1, peak expiratory flow rate, forced expiratory volume, forced expiratory flow, maximum voluntary ventilation, and total lung capacity. The results of a spirometry test are very dependent on the patient's effort. For example, if the patient gives poor effort during the test or does not use proper technique, the results could be inadequate. You should also know that spirometry testing is often performed before and after a bronchodilator medication is administered in order to assess how well the patient's airways respond to the drug. There are different types of spirometers that are indicated at different times during pulmonary function testing. Here are some of the most common examples: volume displacement, water seal, dry rolling seal, bellows type, flow sensing, portable, and an ultrasonic spirometer. We will be talking more about each of the different types in separate videos. Also, for this one, we just wanted to provide you with a quick overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.